In this session, we are going to discuss different scheduling discipline algorithms. So there are different algorithms are working to decide the CPU scheduling disciplines. So they are the of the types FCFS scheduling, first come first serve scheduling, shortest job first, SJF scheduling, priority scheduling, round robin scheduling, multi-level queue scheduling, and multi-level feedback queue scheduling. So these are the different scheduling disciplines. So here, as a discussion, I'm going to discuss this FCFS scheduling discipline. So I've given the heading as FCFS scheduling discipline algorithm. So let us suppose this problem has been given. That means we are having P1, P2, P3, three processes are there. We are having the burst time given 24:33. We shall have to decide, say, waiting time, turnaround time, response time, whatever we require. So average waiting time will be calculating after drawing the required NAT chart. So now I'm going for this NAT chart. Okay. So now we are going to draw one NAT chart using FCFS scheduling discipline. So now we are having first P1, it will be starting from 0 up to 24. P1 will be executing. First come first serve means at first I shall go for P1, then P2, then P3 in this order, because they have given in this order only. So now then I shall go for P2, and P2 will have a burst time of 3 units. You know the burst time. Burst time means it is requiring the time required to for process to get completed. And then I shall go for P3, and P3 will take another 3 units of time. So P3 will take another 3 units of time. So if I write this one as 27, here I'm writing this one as 30. Because 3 units, I should not write 3, because I should go for this 24 plus 3, 27, and then 27 plus 3, 30 will be the finishing time. So that is the total duration. So if you calculate the average Now we are going to calculate the average waiting time. How to calculate the average waiting time? So now see, for P1, there is no waiting time for P1. For P2, the waiting time is 24. Now for P3, the waiting time is 27. So that is the waiting time is 27. So now if you go for the average, it is coming as this. So it is 17. In this way, the waiting time, average waiting time, can be calculated. Okay, here you see, if you go for the turnaround time, say average turnaround time, so now it is the time between the submission and the completion. So for P1, the turnaround time is 24. For P2, all of them have arrived, so that's why all of them were available from instant 0. So P2 will have the total turnaround time is 27. And P3 will have the turnaround time of 30. So if you do the calculation, then you are getting the average turnaround time. Okay, now if you calculate the throughput, throughput means number of processes completed per unit time. So in 30 units, I have completed 3 processes. So now if you go for 1 per unit time, so that is the throughput. So per unit means you are going for unit time. So now out of 30, in this 30 units of duration, I have completed 3 processes. So 1 unit duration, I have completed these processes. So that means 3 by 30 will be the duration. So that is my throughput. So now in this way, the average waiting time, the turnaround time, and this, yep, working. In this case, the average waiting time and the response time will be the same, because all the processes are having the response time is equal to the respective waiting time. So in this way, I can do the calculations accordingly. So numerical problems will be coming in your GATE exam on these particular scheduling disciplines. So you should have to answer them properly. I think you have got the logic. How did I calculate these particular values? Thanks for watching this video.